This is your RAF reporter. Sees all, knows all. Release Group 73. Venice. Here in this recently liberated city, we found plenty going on. In the square in front of St. Mark's, there was a parade of Italian patriot forces in honor of the liberating army. These partisans did great work in ousting the Germans from northern Italy. It was mainly through their efforts that the resistance collapsed so quickly. After the ceremony, something we couldn't afford to miss, a trip in a gondola. No, the Germans didn't flood all the streets before they left. They've always been this way. An Italian airfield. What are these chaps doing at this petrol dump? At first sight, it looks as though they're just on the old job, preparing fuel to put into auxiliary tanks. But what's this? Powder, eh? And then they fill the tanks. What's the fiddle? The tanks are attached in the usual way to the wings of a fighter. Then two hand grenades are fitted, one inside and the other outside, with a wire to enable the pilot to pull out the pins. And here goes. Yes, they're the new firebombs. Already they've been used very successfully on enemy troop concentrations and strong points. Now that the German war is over, they'll be used exclusively for frying Japs, with or without chips. Greece. A pleasant escorted tour around the ruins of the Acropolis. Mind you, we were far more interested in the young escort than in the old ruins. But what's this? Competition, eh? Competition, yes. But there seems plenty of escort to go around. Oh, yes, but definitely. You know, there's one thing I always say about the RAF. Everybody always pulls their weight. There's no leaving things for others to do. Yes, sir, that's our motto. Share and share alike. What's that? Who's fireproof?
The Indian Ocean covers 16,000 square miles, and the people who dwell upon its shores live in a world apart. But a certain yellow nation threatened these people, and so with every dawn, the people hear this noise. A Catalina coming home from the day's first patrol. Many of the native harbours are now bases, and side by side with the huts are the tents of the RAF, and side by side with the fishing boats are the flying boats and the launches of air-sea rescue.
Here in Ceylon, it's hot. From the first thing in the morning to the last thing at night. And when you get up, the heat gets up too and hits you for six. But my last billet was a Nissen hut somewhere near Harwich. And getting up somewhere near Harwich could be much more uncomfortable. But in any case, the job has to go on. Flying boats have still got to have their dailies, even though it is umpteen in the shade. And that engine is like a hot plate. There are generally quite a few of the locals around, coping with their own jobs or helping us out with some of ours. And hour by hour throughout the day, the cats are made ready for takeoff, and the sweeps must be kept going. The Indian Ocean is quite some pond, and there's plenty of water to keep an eye on. The last kite has gone, there's time for pleasure. A dip in the pani, that's local slang for water. A sail around the bay. And it's then that you realise that Ceylon has got something. But sometimes there's trouble. The Catalina, way out there in the blue, spots something and down she goes to investigate. Looks like a dinghy. Yep, somebody's ditched.
Yesterday morning, at 2:41 a.m., General Jodl signed the act of unconditional surrender to the Allied Expeditionary Force. The German war is therefore at an end.
Thank you.
From all these operations, thousands of our aircraft did not return. But for every life that was lost, a wheel ceased turning, a furnace went out, a train did not run. And by their sacrifice, a mighty war machine was broken and a continent freed. After the Nazi collapse, the last prison walls came crashing down. Allied forces poured into Holland. And as the walls came down, the crawling things beneath scuttled to and fro to escape inevitable justice. The Quislings, the collaborators, the traitors. The Allied forces brought freedom. And at the same time, they brought something else. Holland was starving. There were no cats left to kill. Even the dustbins were empty. In a few days, Bomber Command dropped over 2,000 tons of food, and the immediate crisis was past. Dropped on Europe, the bombers flew back and forth. On the way out to France, Belgium, Holland, and Germany, they carried food and urgent supplies. On the way back to Britain, they carried men, ex-prisoners of war. On some days, the RAF landed as many as 1,800 at one airfield alone. These are men who have not stepped on the soil of Britain for many months. Men who were captured at Dunkirk, St. Valery, Crete, Knightsbridge, Tobruk. At the RAF stations where they landed, we did what we could to help them. We gave them food, tea, cigarettes, and what many wanted most of all, English conversation. But there were many stories to tell of oppression, suffering, loneliness, liberation. Many had souvenirs to show, German knives, pictures, watches. But there were many who had no souvenirs, who did not wish to talk, many who just wanted to sit quietly, to read an English newspaper, to send a message home. Liberation, homecoming, rejoicing. That was VE Day in Europe. But while the bonfires blazed from Piccadilly to Aberdeen, we remembered those of you who were not here to see them. For this victory is your victory too, and your V Day cannot now be far off.